This is the A7S2 internal mic. I will make some peripheral noises so that you can judge how directional sound is. I am now testing Audio-Technica's Pro24-CM mic mounted on the camera and running on a battery. This is Audio-Technica's ATR6550 on its super cardioid setting. We have normalized all audio so that my voice sounds roughly at the same level, and we will use those gains as a reference for future tests. You are now listening to Rode's Videomic Pro in its plus 20 dB setting. This is the one I expect to come on top, because of the price, but not only. This one here is Audio-Technica's ATR3350, and of course, it being a lapel mic, it doesn't really compare to the rest, but we can use it as a reference, and also it might be a budget option you have not considered for your recordings. And finally, we've got Audio-Technica's AT2020USB+, which we use mostly for voiceover work. We've got great appreciation for this brand, and that's why we're testing mics, because we're thinking of using the Rode instead for camera work. For the ambient test, I'll be speaking from behind the camera. This is the A7S2 internal mic. You are now listening to the Pro24-CM. This being a stereo mic, I expect it to pick up lots of ambient sound. This is the ATR6550. Before, we had it set to super cardioid in order to focus on the subject, but if we wanted to pick up ambient sound instead, we could switch to normal or cardioid, like so, and then balance the audio levels in post. This is the Rode Videomic Pro. It is supposed to be very directional, but also very sensitive to any sound. Whether you pick a directional mic or an omnidirectional one determines the type of work that you're gonna do with it. You are now listening to the ATR3350, placed at an arbitrary distance from the camera. This is an omnidirectional mic, but you can expect its performance to decline with distance. And finally, this is the AT2020USB+, while talking from behind it. This one records directly to a computer, so it is not one that you would take on a shoot outdoors. A7S2 internal mic. Pro24-CM with included dead cat. ATR6550 with included windscreen. Rode Videomic Pro. We can try turning on the high pass filter. Like so. ATR3350 with included windscreen. AT2020USB+. We can always try adding a studio windscreen to it. Like so. So, for us, overall, the one that ticks most boxes is the one we're using right now, the Videomic Pro. That's mainly because of its plus 20 dB setting that allows us to record with very low in-camera gain, and also because of its Rycote layer suspension that minimizes noises when working with the camera. That, along with the audio quality, makes the difference in price easily worthwhile.